We want to determine the least common multiple, or LCM, of 4 and 6 using what's often called a fraction wall, or rods. Let's begin by reviewing the definition of least common multiple. The least common multiple, or LCM, of two whole numbers is the smallest number that is a multiple of both. The least common multiple is also the smallest number that can be divided evenly by both whole numbers. Let's first show how we can determine the LCM of 4 and 6 using our fraction wall. We'll begin by defining the smallest rod as one whole. So we also have a 2 rod, a 3 rod, a 4 rod, and a 6 rod, as well as an 8 rod, 12 rod, and 24 rod. To determine the least common multiple in 4 and 6, we want to build a train of 4 rods and 6 rods and determine the shortest train where the 4 train and 6 train would be the same length. So looking at the 4 rods and 6 rods, notice how the shortest train with a common length would start here and end here. So looking at the 4 rods, notice how it would take 1, 2, 3, 4 rods to form the train of this length. So we have 3 copies of 4, or 3 times 4. This has a length of 12. Now looking at the 6 rods, notice how the train would have a length of 1, 2, 6 rods. So it has 2 copies of 6 rods, so the length is 2 times 6, also 12, which means 12 is the least common multiple of 4 and 6. Notice how these two trains also have the same length as 1 12 rod. So again, the least common multiple of 4 and 6 does equal 12. Now if we have loose rods, let's also show how this would work. We would begin with a 4 rod and a 6 rod. And again, we're trying to build the shortest train built with only 4 rods and only 6 rods, where the two trains would have the same length. So because the 4 rod is shorter, we'd add another 4 rod to form a 4 rod train, which would look like this. Now notice how the 6 rod is shorter, so we'd add a 6 rod to form a 6 rod train, which would look like this. And now because the 4 rod train is shorter, we'd add another 4 rod to the 4 rod train. And when we do this, notice how now the two trains have the same length. And again, this is the shortest train where these two trains would have the same length. So the length of the trains represents the least common multiple. So here we have 3 copies of 4, 3 times 4, which would be 12. Here we have 2 copies of 6, or 2 times 6, which is also 12. Once again, verifying the least common multiple of 4 and 6 is 12. I hope you found this illustration helpful.